That was a piece called Hide the Trees. And now we're going to do a piece called Cusp.
Thank you.
here tonight, and thank you for coming out. Great to see all these wonderful faces. Very nice. We have those two pieces were from a while ago, Stickman pieces. We'll play you a variety of music tonight, and we're going to do a few pieces from our very new album. In fact, it's coming out next week, but we have it now, so it's a very new album. The name of that album is Prague Noir, and this is a piece from it called Schattenhaft.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So I'm trying to remember the first and last time I played in Helen was in 2014 with the Crimson Project. Maybe some of you were here or there. I can't even remember the name of the venue. But anyway, I remember that it was a very special night. And it already feels great to be back. And in terms of what we're going to play tonight, we're going to look back to some of the very first pieces. And actually this one that we're going to play now, we worked on the very first day we met with this configuration. And this piece is called Times in St. Ashes. It was released on an EP called Absalom.
Thank you.
So we're going to play a cover piece, a song by Mike Oldfield. It's called Mirage, and I think we've played it in the last like 1.5 years or 2 years. And it's really interesting with this piece because it's very, very minimalistic in a way. It's just one motif that repeats all the time. It's just shifted. But every night, every time I play it, I discover something new somehow. And I don't really know why that is. Maybe it's I discover something about myself, I guess. So this is called Mirage. Thank you. Thank you very much. A few years ago we released an album called Deep, and somehow the word deep, I really can't remember the whole story, but Tony had written a piece that was called Whale Watch, and somehow the word deep presented itself as the album title. And towards the end of the album production process, we still wanted to add something, and there was this little song that we had that we then opened up in the middle, and we added an improvisation. And so we've recently added this piece back into the set. It's called Sepia, and we're going to play a little bit of the melody, and then there's going to be an open, free improvisation in the middle, and then we maybe return back to the theme. Sepia.
Thank you.
it's really funny for me because I remember when I wrote this chord sequence that this piece is based on, that was in a kitchen in Tirol, in Innsbruck. Anyway, so we're going to play another piece from the new album, Prog Noir, and this one is kind of a little bit tongue-in-cheek. It's based on a poem that Tony wrote, and it's called Plutonium, and you'll understand why. Status is a mess. Since its namesake has been, shall we say, downsized, will its electrons suddenly be less? Cue the music of yes. Sight, while a band
plays loudly off-key. Cue the music of Tchaikovsky.
Trouble there trying to gaffer tape and flip it over on a tom-tom. That's the inside scoop. That's backstage stuff. You wouldn't usually get to hear that stuff, but that's what happened. So I'm going to tell you about the next song. I have a small problem with this mic stand that it just won't come far enough, close enough to me, but nothing we can do about that. So let's advance. It's this screw right here. They've got a set screw in it or something. It won't adjust. I worked on it, but you can try it, but anyway. No, there's another way to do this. Yay. It's kind of like, I'm doing a talk show now, yeah? It's the Mike Douglas Show for all you older Americans. Okay, let's think here. We're going to move on to the next piece. Oh, awesome, thank you. In case I do have to sing a little bit later, if you call that singing. The next piece we're going to do is called Horatio. And at least in America, that's a very strange name. I've never known anyone named Horatio. Is anyone here named Horatio? Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. But one day, we were playing in Chicago, I think it was, and it was a woman. She shouted out, "It's me!" Unbelievable. So all this time, I figured it was a guy. And like I say, I work off the lyric of the song more than the music score, if you want to call it a score. Which reminds me, we have a book called Score, don't we? I just segued right into that. Marcus does read. Tony, of course, went to music school and all that stuff. He reads great. And they transcribed all their parts, and there's a music book. So if you're a tapping guitar enthusiast or you want to transpose this stuff to piano or just take it home for a souvenir, at the merch booth, there is a music book called Scored. Am I right? Yeah. I actually haven't looked at it. I don't read, so why would I? Anyway, back to the story of Horatio. I had to put some sort of image in my head to play this piece. So what I did was I figured this guy was probably like, I don't know, from like the 20s or the 30s, you know, before the big war. A guy that wore like a hat, like a fedora, had the big lapel, maybe a double-breasted suit, and like a zoot suit, we used to call them in the States. And this guy probably had a pocket watch, and he'd take his pocket watch and he'd kind of walk down the street, you know. So kind of put me into this mood. And I don't know, he could have been Dutch. I really don't know. But in my mind, the guy was German. Because he keeps saying one word over and 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 over again. And that one word is nine, nine, nine. We'll be right back. tell you another short little story for you. I just don't gab too much, you know. It's dangerous to give the drummer the microphone. As you can see, Tony and I like to stay busy. We just finished touring with Crimson like a week ago. And we ran home for a day or two. We came right back. We started this tour a couple days ago in France. And it was interesting. They gave us these little menthol Kleenexes. I see you're using a lot of those tonight. Tony's going through them. I've got the sniffles as well. But it's beautiful weather here. I love it. What I was going to tell you about is last year, during one of the breaks, the three of us were taken to Japan. Actually, there's a man at the merch booth. His name is Horatio. No, his name is Leonardo. And you should go meet Leonardo. Very interesting character. He's lived all over the world. He can tell you fascinating stories, speaks every language. And he had this idea to take the three of us to Japan and do a special show joined by David Cross. David Cross was the King Crimson violin player in the 70s band, 73, 74, Lark's Tongue and Aspic, Star Like a Bible Black, some beautiful records, great player. So we met him there in Osaka, and we did two shows that day, semi-improvised. He joined us for some of our songs, and we worked a little bit on his material and improvised a lot. And then the next day we did two shows in Tokyo. And part of the deal with the Japanese was they recorded that, and they got to have an exclusive release for 1 year. He negotiated a deal for 1 year. So we got the tapes back about 6-8 months ago. Marcus chopped them up, remixed them, and they're available out there at the merch, and it's called Midori. It's a very interesting record that, like I said, it's semi-improvised, but it features the great David Cross. And we use that Midori record because we wanted to spend a little more time composing the material that's on our new Prognor record, a word I do not pronounce well, especially in France. Anyway, we're going to do the most recent piece on the Prognor record, which is called Mantra. The writing began actually quite a while ago, 2 years ago, but this piece came a little bit later, and we'll give it a stab, so to speak. Yeah? You guys? Yeah? Kind of a peaceful, gentle mantra.
Thank you.
Tony's going to tell you about the next one.
All right. I won't say much. Well, it's a little like plutonium was taking a scientific theme of our beloved Pluto has been taken away from us as a planet. This is an older song of ours that plays with the idea of super colliders and of soup. It's called Soup.
Yeah.
Super Collider itself in CERN in Geneva just a few weeks ago. It was a really, really fantastic and moving experience. I didn't tell them about that song. Maybe they found out anyway, but they were very gracious. It was wonderful. I think it's about time we did a King Crimson piece. Here's one from the 80s, back near when I first joined the band. This is called Sartori in Tangier. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Some nights I'm running just a second behind on everything, and it's hard, a little hard sometimes to catch up and hit the right button for the next song where things will be trouble. We're going to play for you the title song of our very new CD, Prague Noir. This is called Prague Noir. If it's about anything, it's about our life playing progressive music. You know, sometimes dark world, but always fun for us and always rewarding. There you go. That's the secret behind the scenes. I turn Marcus up. We have these groovy little Southern arms. I'm living in Forget to mention it, sometimes I do. After we play, we'll go upstairs and start a beer, and then we'll come out in case anybody has anything they want signed or anything. We always will do that out at the wherever the table is where they're selling merch. So I want to mention that. Everybody, all right? You've been wonderful. We realize this is challenging music, some of our music, and we appreciate how open-minded you are and wonderful about it. We're gonna give you another King Crimson piece, and it's one that's very challenging for us also. This is, Pat and I have been playing this on tour with King Crimson. Pat was one of the writers back in the early 2000s, and it's a challenge for seven of us to do it with King Crimson, and here we are with only three of us, and five of those parts fall to Marcus, because I'm playing the bass. So it's quite a challenge and a good way to end our set. So this is called Level 5.
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. Marcus Reuter on the touch guitar. Pat Mastalago on electronic and acoustic drum. And myself, Tony Revin on the Chapman stick. Thank you.
If you don't know, Tony has a great website with a blog that he's been doing forever, since before the internet even existed, probably. And he posts all these pictures, so you'll find yourself there. And because he was just talking about his trip to the Super Collider, if you go into his blog and check back a week or two ago, you'll see some fascinating pictures that he took there in CERN. Is that pronouncing it correctly? And the next piece is an odd one because we did an improvised record. We're in a race to go to South America, and we didn't have a record prepared, so we decided let's just get together and improv. And I prepared stuff at home and brought. We did this in Tony's little attic up in his house, so there's no drum set, but I prepared stuff and played an iPad and an iPhone and a laptop, and they improvised along. Marcus had already set up some key structures. You can tell them. Tell them more while I prep up here.
Anyway, yeah, this piece is called Open, and also the record that we put out at that point was called Open. And somehow it's become a real favorite among the fans and friends, and we've played it at almost every show. So it's really fascinating. It's an improvisation, but in a way, it's always the same, but it's also always different, because we just have like this key center, C sharp, and Pat has some electronic rhythms that he's using. But other than that, it's open. And but we've played like 250 times, and I can still play it without getting bored. It's funny. Okay, so this is the last piece of the night, Open.
Thank you. Thank you.